So Meta just offered OpenAI's developers, top developers, $100 million signing bonus, $100 million signing bonus. But while Meta is offering $100 million bonuses, humans like you and me, college graduates like you and me, can't get jobs, can't get interviews at 60K. Why? Well, it's because the skills that you have currently are not relevant. And there's a bunch of college kids that are gonna wake up in 6 months to a year and 2 years, and they're gonna be like, holy crap, I was sold a bad bill of goods. I got scammed because the skills that I learned in college don't matter anymore. AI is moving so fast, so quickly, that they're not gonna be able to keep up. And I think there's an equal problem for millennials and for Gen Xers. The skills that you've been working on for the last 20, 30 years are soon gonna be irrelevant. So there's two issues here, and we're gonna look at some of the data here. One of the challenges that the older generations have is that you've been mastering skills that ChatGPT and AI can master very, very quickly. And so your experience and skill set isn't quite as valuable as it used to be. Now, you do have some advantages that we're going to talk about, but that experience can be easily replaced. A lot of the entry-level experience, data, memorization can all be replaced with AI. But you do have a unique advantage, which is your wisdom, real world experience, okay? And your ability to communicate with humans one-on-one. You know, Generation Alpha, Generation, is it Beta, Bravo, whatever the next generation is, they're not gonna have the same kind of person-to-person experience and connection that you're gonna have. They're not gonna understand leadership as well. So that's your advantage. Your disadvantage as a millennial or a Gen Xer is you're not catching on quickly enough. You're not catching on quickly enough, man. I don't have to tell you guys, if you're not using AI all day, every day, you're behind the curve, my friend. You're not gonna be hireable. If you don't have, if I go to your LinkedIn profile and there's nothing on there about how you're using AI to solve interesting problems, you're wasting your time. 78% of employers are looking right now, 78% are looking for people that are using AI. If I can't hire anyone in my firm that's not using AI. I'll give you an example. I recently hired someone to do product research and do research, market research, SWOT analysis, data analysis. Paid the guy $700, comes back 4 days later with 4 pages worth of data. And by the way, it was not bad, but it wasn't that comprehensive. I went to Grok, I used the deep research function. I was able to get 20 pages of data. I was getting sources like from Oxford, from the World Economic Forum, from the Better Business Bureau, .gov. I mean, we're getting within 5 minutes. I was like, bro, I can't, what are you doing, man? You just charged me $500 for 4 pages. Look what I got. And I showed him, look what I got in 5 minutes. You're crazy, dude. It was free. I actually think I'm paying for a premium account. It's like $9 a month. But the point remains, and that's a good example of how you're not relevant. And the skills that you've built are not relevant. And if you're not learning the AI stuff, you're not going to be relevant. So again, as a millennial, as a Gen Xer, that is your weakness. That is your blind spot. That is the blind spot that is very solvable just by getting in these tools and playing around and learning how to use them. And I'm not just talking about how do I generate a list with ChatGPT. ChatGPT, write me an email. I mean, I think that's good, but that's table stakes. You're not actually, I mean, the key here is gonna be building out AI agents and putting AI problems together, finding problems within your workspace, finding problems within your employer's workspace, using AI to solve them. I'll give you an example. If I was looking to find a new client, which I always am, looking for new ways to serve people, as a fractional CMO or again, AI software development, whatever. If I was looking for a way to get hired by a company or solve a company's problem or get hired by a company, I would just go to their website. I would plug it in to a program like ChatGPT and say, what are some interesting problems that this company might have? How can AI solve them? And then when I went into the interview, that's exactly what I would talk about. I would say, hey, you know, by the way, I was seeing this and this and this. These are some potential opportunities and threats. This is how AI might serve a purpose. This is how AI might solve some problems. So if I was trying to get hired, that's something I would do right off the cuff. Of course, I'd make sure that I actually knew what I was talking about. That's where the practice of getting in and learning takes place. That's it. That's it. And it's not that hard. You just, you know, I talked about this in yesterday's video. You can use a program like Replit, like Grok, like ChatGPT, the OpenAI API. It's, you know, you can put these things together pretty easily and get some really insane results. But here's, I want to talk about, you know, we talked about Gen X, millennials, where your blind spot is, but let's talk about the young people, because young people have another blind spot. You know, on one hand, Gen Z, Gen Alpha, people, you know, you've grown up in this tech world, and you're gonna catch on to the AI much more quickly. You probably, generally speaking, gonna have a harder time connecting with people face to face because your whole world has been internet based. You know, you're spending more time looking down at your phone in your teens than millennials and Gen Xers did. It's just because the technology wasn't there. And that's okay. That's just something to be aware of. But here's the scary thing. Here's what I think is interesting. This is a stat from TechCrunch. New grad hiring is down 25% at big tech firms from 2023 to 2024. 25%. The unemployment for recent college graduates ages 22 to 27 jumped 5.8% to 5.8%. You're having a harder time finding jobs. It's increasing. Startups cut entry-level roles by 11% in 2024 versus 2023. That's according to SignalFire. So startups are hiring less people. Tech companies hiring less people. They're still paying out the $100 million entry fee, okay, if you really know your stuff. If you really know your stuff. But the problem is, a lot of the times when you're coming in fresh into a company, you're doing entry-level data analysis. You know, you're looking at data, you're filing papers, you're learning the business. And the problem that you have as someone who just recently graduated from college is you haven't had your chance to learn the business yet. You haven't had your chance to earn your stripes. And the problem is that AI can do that immediately. AI can do it immediately. So how do you find your footing? Well, you go in saying that you're AI powered. Same thing. And that I'm kind of explaining it for millennials and Gen Xers. You go in saying, these are the problems you have in your organization. Here's how I'm using AI. And these are some ways that we could streamline some of the processes, shore up some of the weaknesses, reduce expenses, etc. And this is corroborated by the Oxford Economics Report, who said that entry-level jobs in IT support, basic development, are just being automated. It's all being automated. And here's why I really do feel like, I hate to use the term college is a scam, but what is being taught in college is just not is pertinent anymore. What's being taught in, you know, online courses is not as pertinent anymore, because most of the stuff that's being taught is someone saying, hey, this is what worked for me, and I'm gonna show you what I did because it worked for me, it'll probably work for you too. The problem is, what worked for someone last year or even 6 months ago isn't gonna work in the future. It's just not. And I see this a lot in the marketing world, which is where I live, lead generation and marketing. A lot of the skills being taught are just, like, you're gonna teach someone how to run Facebook ads, that you have a course about how to run Facebook ads? I talked about this just this week. Within a year and a half, it's all gonna be AI. AI is gonna run all the ads, gonna run the funnel, it's gonna optimize. Someone's like, oh, well, privacy laws, and they won't be able to do that. Bull crap, bro. AI is gonna do all that. It's gonna do it better than you can. It's gonna understand the algorithm better than you. I mean, Facebook and Meta has an interest in this. Google has an interest in this. Google and Meta want to make sure you get the best return possible. They want you to have the best return, because if you're getting a good return, you're going to keep coming back and spending more money. I'm not saying that marketers don't. You're just not going to be able to do it as good as Meta. You're not as smart as Meta. Sorry. Them's the facts. So again, this is the time to be thinking differently if you want to get that job at that Fortune 500, Fortune 5000 company. You know, you're gonna have to earn your stripes in a different way than previous generations did. And that, you know, again, even, you know, if you're, I was talking to a guy the other day, he's a millennial, he's probably about 40 years old, and he has retired from the Navy, I think, Navy, retired from the military. He said he's having a hard time finding a job. And I kind of asked him, what are you looking for? He's like, well, leadership position. I'm like, great, leadership, great. How are you using AI? Well, you know, I don't know. I don't know if it's for me. I'm like, man, I hate to give advice when people, unless people ask for it. But I said, listen, you know, I started spouting off some of these data points about 61% of CEOs are actively developing AI agents to serve them in their work. What are you doing? You want to be in a leadership role? Are you developing AI agents? If you don't know what an AI agent is, that's a problem. That's a problem for you if you want to maintain a leadership position. If you don't know what an AI agent is, I'll give it to you right now. It's essentially an AI bot that you've trained to execute a task for you. And that could be anything from go to Fiverr, find the top rated graphic designer and ask, you know, start a conversation and see if they're interested in a job building up AI generated images for our website, something like that, right? So if, you know, you're that's probably something you only need done once, you might not build an agent for that, but maybe you do. It depends on the business that you're in. The reality is, though, that you want to create agents that are able to execute basic tasks, and they can do them by themselves. They can generate, they can initiate conversations. Again, if you're not sure where to start, you can start with a program like Replit. You type in the comments below, I'd be happy to answer it. But that's what I would be thinking about. And so I don't want to doom and gloom you. I just think that the opportunities are tremendous. And here's a piece of data that the World Economic Forum brought out. All our friends over there at the World Economic Forum. Man, I love y'all. Klaus Schwab. Y'all are so nice. You're thinking about us. You're thinking about the little guys. I appreciate that. But anyway, they say that they anticipate 78 million new job roles over the next 4 years. 78 million. The highest paying emerging jobs, AI product managers, prompt engineers, AI question answer testers, and AI ethicists. Some of the jobs they expect to take part in. So think about yourself, think about what interests you. If you want anything in leadership, knowing how to manage AI, knowing how to get the most out of AI is important. Over the next 6 to 12 months, it is going to become dramatically important. Every single professional, every single millennial, you want to continue providing for your family. As far as I see it, you either have two options. One option is you can start learning how to do blue collar work. You start doing blue collar hands in the dirt type of work, which, you know, is really hard. I was in the AC industry for about a year. It is hard work, cleaning coils, brother. Working as a plumber, all you know, electrician, all that stuff. You're going to be able to make crazy money. So there's that. But it's hard work. It's very difficult work. Very long hours. Can be dangerous. Hard on your body. Or you could be learning AI and how it is going to, and how you can solve interesting problems with AI. That's where I'm leaning, just because it's fascinating and I think it's potentially much more scalable, you know, as far as value for your time goes. So I want to just kind of bring this to your light. I thought it was fascinating. $100 million. The Sam Altman, Mark Zuckerberg feud is going to be pretty epic. I'm with Zuck on this one. You know, you want to grow a big business, you want to hire the best guys, then you do you, brother. In the meantime, that's them. What about you? What are you going to do to stand out? What are you going to do to make sure you're not part of the growing list of unemployed? Because this is not going to stop. It's going to go faster and faster and faster, especially again for entry-level positions. If you're not a deep expert in your field, if you don't have deep connections, it's going to be harder and harder for you to break through. And I think one of the best ways to do that is by understanding the market you're trying to get into, to understand the business you're trying to get into, have a deep understanding of it, and making it both public and privately known that you understand how AI can play a role in solving those problems. That's it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you next one, all right?